Alright, so the story of Genesis, okay, when the last thing created are the bugs and then the beasts. I think I know why it goes in that order. Okay, I think it's like near livestock. Now, when it goes off and expands until it engulfs the whole bubble. You know, what the whole bubble means is what's in the air. Aircraft. Aircraft have turbines, you know, and I'm sure they suck up bugs, and there's death, insect death, caked on in those turbines. And only death can pay for life. And you have to bring all the souls with you, all the dead. All the dead souls, guy. And your pilot, okay, is man, but in the other reality, in the fourth dimensional Earth, it's literally a land of cats and dogs, like humanoid cats and dogs. And when they bring forth new Earth, they will bring forth probably us. But maybe they'll see everyone like they see themselves. And maybe we'll see everyone like we see ourselves. So all the aliens that are coming over are going to look just like us. Again, they're Rh negative, Rh positive, right hand negative, right hand positive. They're going to be left hand negative, left hand positive. And probably another type, a balanced, a different, a B positive positive or something. Like, you know? A balanced hand, balanced metal, maybe like a BM negative, BM positive. Okay? And if the beasts in this fictitious feline and dogs and cats humanoid reality are the aircraft pilots, okay, life and death, everything comes. Man was created last because you're talking about the pilots and the passengers and the planes and the aircraft. Above the birds, guy. Above all other life. It's the whole plan of ET goes with all life and death. Okay. Now, think of the movie Donnie Darko. It's all about time travel and dimensions. And what happens in Donnie Darko? A jet turbine falls from the sky and lands on his head, killing Donnie. Mind blasted, right? So, what that tells me is that I believe Shelaine Amber Graves had this initial idea while traveling on a plane in her reality. Okay? Or Austin Lee Meredith is having the realization of this scenario while traveling on a plane. Okay? That's where the beasts in our reality are the observers, the two eyes of the dodecahedron and icosahedron, the whole, for the light to come in, for the water to get poured in. And the flood, you know? And where was I going with this? Yeah, and then the beasts are the last thing created before man. The beasts are the observers, and the beasts are the last thing created before man, the sevens. And the seven's the beast, it's the moon. The dark side of the moon, guy. Where all light comes from, the hole. The hole is actually two holes. Meaning like the left and right eye of a dog and the left and right eye of a cat. So, like, I like the Q land bridges. Like, it's like a yellow brick road. Maybe that's what it is. Maybe all the N-1 realities. So, like, all of the galaxies that come from Shelaine Amber Graves, God, the first person to make a cellular energy device in her reality, to get them the 4D, or whatever. We become the N+2, they become the N+1, but the first person to create a cellular energy device, that God, that's the N. Okay? Now everything after or before him is an N-1, N-2, N-3, N-infinity. Those are the yellow brick roads. Those might be like gold islands. I throwing not out there, but like, those just might be the little islands that unite the circles to form cues that connect as a trinity. Where one's bigger, the other one's a little bit, one is bigger, the M plus 2 is the biggest, the M plus 1 is the smallest, and the N would be the second biggest, just slightly smaller than the other one. And all the connecting bits are going to be all the N minus whatevers. I don't know if they'll have life on them, or if they'll be the building blocks of the third dimension. Like a tree could be made of trillions of souls, meaning trillions of previous dimensions, guy. Of entire, like, bubbles, you know? So, like you can go travel to a speck of sand, into that realm, if you wanted to, and come back after a month and have time stay still until you come back so you can go eat supper. It's the whole infinite, the whole Rick and Morty, again, nomenclature. It's new. Gospel. It's new. It's a new paradigm. It's a new creation. It's a recent creation. But it has a lot of similarities. Now, yeah, it's all about different interpretations. Again, you're going to go from the earth as it is now to the earth as it is now plus two new bubbles, so it'll be three bubbles in a one bubble, a 13, you know, with a whole bunch of stuff in between. The central heaven of the three makes a place of the 40 and two places of the 5 and the 0, or a 60 split, where light can bend, but the new singularity or central point is the middle of the Trinity. So the only thing that changes are your eyes. And you're going to have two versions of your higher self there at the same time. What's the expression? Two out of three ain't bad, but I mean... And I have Yellow Brick Road in my head. Wizard of Oz and Elton John even, and he got knighted. So, what's your gold and silver gonna be worth if there's an abundance in the paths that connect the old Earth, new Earth, and, you know, Pandora Earth? And when you move forward ahead, anything new that's going to be created is going to be created off of those three hubs. And the center of the galaxy will always be the way it is. And everything that gets created off new gets created off on the ever-expanding waters, meaning that the Antarctica of the bubble is always creating more room for new galaxies to join our bubble. It's when bubbles join. Now, I'm sure when bubbles join, there's a little bit of bubble that sometimes falls off. Just like with scabs, like when you heal, the scab falls off, you absorb the scab. So there'll be a little bit of rapturing happening or something, but of candida. So, yeah. So if the N plus 2 reality, so if you have a bubble that's an N plus 1, and an M plus 2, if the N plus 2 creates the Trinity, by understanding cellular energy, it creates 3 creates 40, 60, which means 3 makes 4 makes 5, makes 6, which is the new dot, and 7 would represent all the uncircled entities of all the all the galaxies bridging the 3 and the circle that goes around it. Everything that's uncircled. Everything that's uncircled. So in Donnie Darko, when he time travels and that jet engine falls off, what they're saying is that the consciousness of the Earth, it's so backwards and upside down and flipped, is so small that when a Mason learns the secret, the size of the island that is created at Antarctica is so goddamn small. It's like a yellow brick road. It reminds me of the soldiers in China, the clay soldiers that are all in a line. It's like you're creating a grid of islands in Antarctica. Okay, in Antarctica is a circle. Everyone thinks it's solid landmass in the middle. I don't. I think there's a pool of water in the middle. In the pool of water, new landmasses start to appear when people start to learn through Freemasonry what an island is and how this all works. They're tainted. Another, like, soldier is grown as a defender from the underworld when the emperor dies or something. Okay, I literally think there's this flat earth things where it's a square and a pond at the bottom of the earth, and everyone thought it's flat earth and everything. Kind of looks like an eyeball, but it's quartered, and in the quarter there's like, it looks like a grid. There's a grid of islands going to show up. They're going to be very small because it wasn't a divine inception. It wasn't the fool. It wasn't the devil. You can't fake the devil. You can't fake being a Kevin. As much as you try with your TV shows like The Big Bang Theory and with That 70s Show and countless other shows that I see myself as characters in. You can't fake Kevin. You should get that by now. The amount of energy I bring forth with my island, I think, is going to be gargantuan. Another good word from Kill Bill. You don't get to use gargantuan that often. Daryl Hannah says that again, who is also in the original Blade Runner. So, like, yeah, this is the great deception. Even the deceivers are deceived. So they haven't been acting in truth the whole time. That must really grind their grills. But, like, the Earth has a stop slavery expiry date, which we've passed, because I'm activated now, and I've connected with my higher self, and I understand the math of the Earth and the consciousness evolution of all the dimensions that we talk about and hear about in your space stuff. You gotta think like space stuff, but it's not gonna actually be like space stuff. Like, people are gonna look like, it's like the Matrix. It's like it's your higher self, it's your virtual self or something. So you see yourself in whatever ideal situation, you see others. It's like your subconsciousness gets to populate the galaxy. But this is my maze. You have to understand the creation of your maze to link it with your higher self in order to actually fabricate one in the reality. And every time it goes off, you save yourself, your higher self, your soulmate, and your higher self of your soulmate. And when the next iteration happens, okay, when these 12 goes off, so when one goes off and there's 12, there's going to be 12 sets of 4, okay, from each place. And the more in the middle you get, the more you get exponentially affected by it. Because you don't actually have to be there the first. You just need to be part of it and understand it. And if you benefit from it and appreciate it and it creates freedom, then, like, you know, that's good enough. So, like, how many wireless energy devices was it we need? If this is actually a wireless energy device now, where you can cut the cord off everything, then we don't need hydro poles anymore. We don't need hydro lines. We don't need underground hydro lines. We don't need cords. You can cut your cord off. Okay, how does your blender get power through the cord? Oh, you cut it. Okay, well, what's touching the copper windings that are there? The air. I can feel it in the air tonight, oh Lord. If your device is turned off, it will not run. If you turn it on, it will start to blend or brew coffee, I think. It's wireless energy. It's the whole idea of Tesla. It's having electric devices in place to do the job they need to do with free energy for everyone. No devices, no wires, guy, I think. If you make it properly, you're one of them. And then we're all saved. It's like Fibonacci, you bring everything old with you. Even the dead of the bugs and the things that fall from the sky.